Please stand.
Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in a bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. God did not make death, nor does he rejoice in the destruction of the living. For For he fashioned all things that they might have being, and the creatures of the world are wholesome. And there is not a destructive drug among them, nor any domain of the netherworld on earth, for justice is undying. For God formed man to be imperishable. The image of his own nature he made him. But by the envy of the devil, death entered the world. And they who belong to his company experience it. The word of the Lord. From the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, as you excel in every respect, in faith, discourse, knowledge, all earnestness, and in the love we have for you, may you excel in this gracious act also. For you know the gracious act of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, for your sake he became poor, so that by his poverty you might become rich. Not that others should have relief while you are burdened, but that as a matter of equality, your abundance at the present time should supply their needs, so that their abundance may also supply your needs, that there may be equality. As it is written, whoever had much did not have more, and whoever had little did not have less. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. destroyed death and brought life to light through the gospel.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. When Jesus had crossed again in the boat to the other side, a large crowd gathered around him and stayed close to the sea. One of the synagogue officials named Jairus came forward. Seeing him, he fell at his feet and pleaded earnestly with him, saying, "My daughter is at the point of death. Please come, lay your hands on her, that she may get well and live." He went off with him, and a large crowd followed him and pressed upon him. There was a woman afflicted with hemorrhages for 12 years. She had suffered greatly at the hands of many doctors and had spent all that she had. Yet she was not helped, but only grew worse. She had heard about Jesus and came up behind him in the crowd and touched his cloak. She said, "If I but touch his clothes, I shall be cured." Immediately her flow of blood dried up. She felt in her body that she was healed of her affliction. Jesus, aware at once that power had gone out from him, turned around in the crowd and asked, "Who has touched my clothes?" But his disciples said to Jesus, "You see how the crowd is pressing upon you, and yet you ask, 'Who touched me?'" And he looked around to see who had done it. The woman, realizing what had happened to her, approached in fear and trembling. She fell down before Jesus and told him the whole truth. He said to her, "Daughter, your faith has saved you. Go in peace and be cured of your affliction." While he was still speaking, people from the synagogue official's house arrived and said, "Your daughter has died. Why trouble the teacher any longer?" Disregarding the message it was reported, Jesus said to the synagogue official, "Do not be afraid. Just have faith." He did not allow anyone to accompany him inside except Peter, James, and John, the brother of James. When they arrived at the house of the synagogue official, he caught sight of a commotion, people weeping and wailing loudly. So he went in and said to them, "Why this commotion and weeping? This child is not dead, but asleep." And they ridiculed him. Then he put them all out. He took along the child's father and mother and those who were with him and entered the room where the child was. He took the child by the hand and said to her, "Talitha koam," which means, "Little girl, I say to you, arise." The girl, a child of 12, arose immediately and walked around. At that, they were utterly astounded. He gave strict orders that no one should know this, and said that she should be given something to eat. The Gospel of the Lord. That was a longer form of the gospel, and as long as I'm the priest here, you don't ever have to worry about listening to a short form of anything, because Father Patrick, our scripture scholar in the seminary, told us not to use the short form, because he said you're only cheating your people when you do that, because there's a lot of details in the full account of a gospel that you miss when you have a short form. So I've promised you a gift for the rest of the time I'm your pastor. You always get the long form. There is nothing more heart-rending than watching a life fade from a beloved member of our family. We've all gone through it. Some of us may have gone through it during this pandemic, which some of the circumstances made it even harder. And oftentimes, children don't understand this. But for those of us who have, we've had myriads of sad and joyful experiences. We have loved profoundly, and we've developed fulfilling relationships, all of which have given each of us the gift of knowing just how truly precious the gift of life is. Life is a precious gift because all people are created in the image and likeness of God. You will always hear that from me. And God has a plan for each person. In today's Gospel from St. Mark, we hear of two distinct yet similar stories of people grasping for life, life that flows ultimately from Jesus Christ himself. First of all, St. Mark's Gospel tells of a woman who has suffered greatly for 12 years from a hemorrhage and had spent all that she had to get well. And she didn't get well. The Gospel tells us she only got worse. The second story in the Gospel involves Jairus' daughter, who is in the beginning of the Gospel at the point of death. And her father Jairus will do anything to bring her back from the brink of death. Love for life has these two Gospel characters approach Jesus, the divine physician, with hope against hope. Jairus says to Jesus, "Please come." And the woman with the hemorrhage states, "If I but." We can come to recognize that life is flowing out of the hemorrhaging woman's body, and that life, towards the end of the Gospel, life has already gone out of the body of Jairus' daughter. However, in response to their tremendous faith in him, Jesus allows the power of life to spring forth from his body, which heals the hemorrhage and restores life to Jairus' daughter. In both cases, Jesus Christ, we could say, his power has passed through physical contact, through that human touch. The woman touches the hem of Jesus' garment, and Jesus himself takes the hand of Jairus' daughter. Both the woman and Jairus demonstrate a profound faith, and both have their deepest desires for healing granted, because they had profound faith in Jesus Christ. Death has encroached, yet the author of life turns death back. St. Mark's healing stories reveal Jesus Christ to be the Lord of life. Death and debilitating illness and chronic medical conditions shatter any illusion of our own control over life. The fragility of human life turns our eyes and our hearts ultimately to Jesus Christ, the author of life, when we are equipped with nothing but utter faith. In today's first reading from the Book of Wisdom, recall that God fashioned all things that they might have been, that is, life itself. And we know that Jesus Christ overcomes death with the healing power that brings full and abundant life. The Lord heals us through his true abiding presence and grace in the sacraments, especially the sacraments of anointing of the sick, the sacrament of reconciliation, and the sacrament of the Holy Eucharist. I'm sure that each one of us could stand up and give a personal witness to Jesus Christ's healing touch and presence in the confessional. When we've confessed our mortal sins, sins that have wounded our souls, and how after our confession, we truly indeed did feel that warm, compassionate embrace of God's divine mercy through his Son, Jesus Christ. Listen to these beautiful words from St. John Vianney, the patron saint of all priests. When speaking of going to confession, he said, and I quote, "When one is going to confession, one should understand what one is going to do. One can say that one is going to take out the nails from our Lord." End quote. Furthermore, I'm sure that each of us could stand up and share and give witness to a similar account of being fully aware of the true presence of the risen Jesus Christ after we have received Holy Communion. These are gifts to us to strengthen our faith that Jesus Christ is fully aware of our hardships, of our trials, of our tribulations, and of our crosses in life. To encounter Jesus Christ's power over life, we have to acknowledge, as did Jairus and the hemorrhaging woman, this fragile hold that we have on life. Such an acknowledgement is a profound act of faith. So we are faced with two questions. Do we ourselves have faith? Do we have faith to reach out and touch and be touched, allow ourselves to be touched by Jesus Christ, so that whatever is dead within us may be healed and restored to life? And would Jesus ever turn and ask us, "Who has touched my clothes?" As human beings, we often avoid the reality of death as much as we can. Yet death is a natural part of the cycle of life, which we cannot avoid. It is good news indeed that Jesus Christ's inauguration of God's kingdom vanquishes death itself, destroys the grips of sin that they have on us, and restores eternal life. Death, however, not only means the cessation of physical life, but also all those everyday ways in which we die to ourselves. We surrender more fully our wills to God's will, to conform ourselves to Jesus. In a Christian mystery, death is a doorway to life. Just as Jairus and the hemorrhaging woman overcame their fears of death and accordingly received life from Jesus Christ, so must we each surrender our own wills in order to encounter Jesus Christ and to receive life. Both of these people from St. Mark's Gospel entrusted themselves to Jesus by seeking him out. Do we seek him out? Each was moved beyond the known, that of illness and death, to reach into the unknown, to reach with faith to Jesus Christ and the new possibilities for life. Risking disappointment, mockery, and ridicule, both reached out to Jesus with confidence and firm faith that Christ would respond compassionately and mercifully. In our own times of need, they each show each of us the way of healing and wholeness is only through our Lord Jesus Christ, so that whatever is dead within us may be restored through his divine mercy. Praise be Jesus Christ, now and forever.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. God never intended us to die. He created us for life, but we chose death. Christ, our Redeemer, restores us to life, and we come to our Heavenly Father praying through him.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer. That God will strengthen the bond of unity between the faithful and the pastors of the church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our civil leaders, that they will enact laws that promote truth, authentic justice, and a culture of life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For blessings on all families gathered together at this time of year for reunions or for a time of rest, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That people everywhere will have an unfailing respect for all persons, from conception to natural death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the safety of those in the military and for police officers, firefighters, and all first responders, may they be protected by the intercession of St. Michael the Archangel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may be comforted and healed, and that those who have died may share the joys of heaven. We pray especially for Elizabeth Crowley, for whom this Mass is offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Please pause now and add your own personal intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Almighty Father, our lives rest in your hands. Trusting in your providence or care, we bring our petitions before you. We make our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
lift up your hearts.
Lift up the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Michael the Archangel, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Lawrence, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all within me, his holy name.
One bread, one bottle, and more than that.
Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. We'll offer the prayer in time of pandemic. Lord Jesus, you came to bring salvation to our world. You humbled yourself to accept death on a cross. Be with us as we confront the spread of the coronavirus with courage and hope. Be present to the sick and to those who accompany them in their suffering. Strengthen our medical professionals and caregivers. Comfort families who are separated from one another. Protect those who are at risk of the virus in their work. Grant wisdom to our civic officials and perseverance to scientists. Spare us from the ravages of this illness and console us in our uncertainty and fear. Unite us in hope, enlighten us in faith, and give us the grace as a church to love one another as you have loved us. Through the intercession of our Heavenly Mother Mary and Saint Joseph, we make this prayer as we place our trust in you. Amen. Have a blessed week, everyone.